No, you last year. Numbers. Okay. Hello. Hello.
Yeah. Hello. Are you
there? Are you hearing me?
Good morning, and thank you for the opportunity to join you here today and to address you. And when Madam Pierce called me about 2 weeks ago, I was a bit surprised because normally speaking, as you know, doctors, we are, or you are under, I keep on saying we, but it should be you, are under the Ministry of Civil Service. But it's a pleasure to be here, and thank you, Madam Pierce, for the invitation to address the doctors. I congratulate you for completing your internship. And many of you would have heard on the first day of your internship that it's a mountain to climb. And I can assure you that you haven't come to the top of a mountain, but at the base of another major, bigger mountain. So you just, come to the top of Mount Koromapa, and what awaits you is Mount Everest. Okay. So please don't celebrate yet. It's a mark of your movement towards the ultimate completion and attainment of your life's goals and career. And always remember that your career will take you many places. And the start of this new year is a good time to reflect on how we arrived here. And it's always important to think back about the many things that brought you to this place. On Saturday evening, I was at Sylvia's wedding. And when Sylvia was my intern, a few months ago, she said, "You have to come to my wedding." So me being me, I said, "Yes." And all of a sudden, she reminded me when I came to ED about 2 weeks ago, "Hey, my wedding is 2 weeks from now." So I had to clear my diary on Saturday night to make sure I was there. But I was reminding Sylvia and Praveen that they were there, sitting there at the top of the table, and in wedding bliss, as a doctor and as an engineer. Based on the platform that their forefathers had prepared for them, but also the hard work that they got from there. And I think it's important sometimes when you sit now at the top of Mount Koromapa, and as you survey Mount Everest before you, which is your medical career, to actually think back that it's all been about hard work. And hard work is what is expected from you from here on. There have been many initiatives of government, and one of them has been the implementation of the National Health Call Center, which provides a convenient way for patients to give feedback. And I'm a person that believes in feedback, whether it be negative or positive. And I love negative feedback, not because that I can look at negative feedback and gossip about it or rebuke it, but I love negative feedback because it's a mechanism by which I can relook at myself and the way I provide service and the way that I act and react, and hope that I will be able to change the things that I can change to make me a better professional. And I think that's something that we in the medical profession should take on board, very seriously, the fact that we serve and we must receive feedback. And many a times we must stop just being happy about receiving positive feedbacks, but also be happy when we receive negative feedback, because it is opportunities for us to grow. And I've had an opportunity to look at the feedback, and obviously there's been more than 2,000 complaints that have come through. The big institutions like CWM, Notok and Labasa obviously carry the most share. So if you look at it, it seems standardized in a sense that the bigger the institution, the bigger the service, the more likely you're going to have complaints. So what can stand out as a sore thumb is if a small health center in the middle of nowhere has 10 feedbacks in a month. than complaints in the month. So that's, you know, just some of the things that I, as I looked at it with the assessments that I got. The other thing is, when it comes down to actually, what are the things that actually are doctor-oriented? And the common things there are poor communication, not making the right diagnosis, and the attitude. And because of that, I'm sorry to say, but there are two or three doctors that have had to be disciplined in the last year or so through the Ministry of Civil Service, with support through the feedback mechanisms within the particular, through the Ministry of Health. And when I look at it, and I realize that we really have a long way to go. If we talk about ourselves being a noble profession, then we have to be noble in many ways. And we are called to be managers, you are called to be a leader, wherever you go. And remember, in the health center situation, there will be probably be yourself, your two nurses, your zone nurses in your nursing stations, your cleaner, orderly, and maybe a driver. But you're a leader and not a follower. And it is your role to empower the people who beside you to be leaders too. And on a personal note, one thing that I do quite often when I go through CWM in the morning, when I do my ward rounds at 7 or 5 or even 3 o'clock in the morning, I shake the hand of everybody I meet. I shake the hand of the cleaner. I shake the hand of the cooker, the driver, because their roles are as important as ours. And we shouldn't forget that they look up to us. And because they look up to us, we must look up to them, not look down on them. The government, obviously, as you know, has gone through certain reforms to make employment better, but also service better. And these are, just to name a few, the newly implemented employment contracts and pay scale for our staff. When I was an intern, my starting salary was 17,200. My colleagues over here, they started with 13,000. You this morning, when you were interns, you probably received maybe 3 to 4 times that. So you can see within the last 20 years, there's been significant effort on behalf of government to recognize the contributions that we as a medical profession have in society. There's been additional funding for local initiatives and tackling backlogs and also maintenance. As you know, we've also gone into subsidy of dialysis services to all Fijians and a significant funding for the ministry via the annual budget processes. When I travel throughout the country, I am always encouraged by the positive feedback that I receive. And at the same time, I see the challenges that our health workers go through. And I can assure you with the Public Secretary for Health that we're working very hard to ensure the facilities that you have are also state-of-the-art facilities. That it doesn't matter whether you're in a small health center or in a major hospital, that the facilities look similar. That if it's quartiles in the main hospital, we will aspire to give you quartiles in your health center. Yes, sir. She was looking over here. But we aspire to ensure that the facilities are great facilities. I've been stressing the main elements in the Ministry of Professional Development, professionalism, punctuality, customized staff experience, efficiency and infrastructure. And if you think about it, professionalism and efficiency in the health center, in the subdivision medical area, is a place where you provide leadership. With infrastructure, obviously, you have the general services component, the corporate component of health, that will support you with that. But you need to take leadership in professionalism and efficiency. I've also asked the Public Secretary for Health that we can have weekly audits in every institution and in every clinical area that we participate in. I've also been going around and meeting the Honua and presenting sincerely wherever I go. And I think it's important that when you go to your next posting, that you go and visit the Honua and visit the district advisory councils and sit down with them. We have to go back to the old ways. In this way, we continue to connect with the people that we are there to serve. Remember that we are there to serve. And they would want to serve us. That is normal. But more importantly, we must remember that we are there to serve. You need to improve the surroundings in our hospital and health centers, and that's the expectations that we place upon you as a leader in the places that you will be. You also need to reduce adverse events, and we have to be proactive in this area and not reactive. We need to identify the causes and implement improvements to prevent them from reoccurring. Fixing those issues is going to take effort. Fixing those issues is going to take money, time, but as a leader, you have to take that responsibility. One of the things that I'm very interested in is developing both the clinical area and the public health area within our Ministry of Health. I've been in theatre for the last 20 years, and I've realized that you can operate so many times, but unless you support and strengthen public health, we will continue to struggle. And as you leave this place and go to your appointments next week, you carry my mandate to strengthen public health in the areas that you know. We know that medicine is a unique profession, and you interact with people. And medicine is all about people interacting with people. And I think it's important to understand, as a leader, you need to be able to coerce, encourage, and support your staff so that you can interact well with the communities that you're part of. It gives you the opportunity to be present at some of the happiest moments in the community and individuals' lives, and also the most tragic. And as you know, sometimes our work can be a matter of life and death. Wherever you're posted, it is vital that you are compassionate. It is vital that you are human. It is vital that you are humble. And it is vital that you shake hands. And you have, and with this, you have the hallmarks of this noble profession. Again, as I said earlier, it saddens me that there are reports of doctors being rude, doctors perceived to be uncaring, and doctors that don't deal appropriately and definitively with patients when they present with a medical or health matter. There will be times when you are confronted with unreasonable, argumentative, or simply unpleasant people or atmosphere. But you must remain calm. You must be cool. You must be cool. You must have ice in your head. Have fire in your heart, burning with passion for the work that you're doing. But your ice, there should be ice in your head. You should be mentally cool, mentally tough. And remember, the internship here is providing you an opportunity to learn to be mentally tough, to be calm under stress. Remember the many times that your consultant talked over you. Remember the many times your registrar ordered you around. Well, I can tell you now that as you face Mount Everest, there will be many more of those instances. But this time around, you're in a position of leadership. And the way you reacted when you were needed is exactly the way you need to react as a medical officer, with calmness, with humility, and with grace. Teamwork is essential, and you must show respect. And you must be punctual. Let it pay off. 8 o'clock started. We need doctors who are proactive. And if you see a colleague who's behaving inappropriately, like Payofa coming late this morning, during morning tea, you need to take Payofa aside and tell him that was inappropriate. You must never come late when the minister is here. So I ask you, please treat your patients and your colleagues and your working environment with care and respect. And I wish you all the very best. And Payofa, you will be on it. And look forward to seeing you successfully completing the next rotation that's before you. So excited to see you today. God bless you, and I will see you in your health center. That's a promise.